The focus of the project has kind of been to explore these karst regions in northern Vietnam, which are these limestone regions that are known to host a lot of species that are known only to occur in these limestone regions.
Ari put this together himself. He wrote most of the grant, he planned the expedition, and I went over there with him for the first few weeks, but you know, I was kind of along for the ride at that point, and I left. And then Ari stayed on and continued this work for several more weeks, going to even more remote areas. And we see this tremendous loss of biodiversity happening in Vietnam. It's sort of a race against time to see what's there before it's gone.
We're in the middle of a biodiversity crisis, so we have these extreme rates of deforestation and limestone quarrying and illegal harvesting. So it's really good to get this basic inventory on, well, how many species do we have? Where are they located? What are they doing? We discovered the new species of odd-scaled snake in kind of this lowland valley region in Hazong province.
The snake that Ari found, there's only a handful of specimens of that entire genus that have ever been seen.
This discovery falls in line with this broader idea, kind of catching up on, well, how many species do we have? And how do we effectively lobby for laws that protect biodiversity? So we should care about biodiversity inherently because these species exist and they're all around us and they help maintain ecological stability in the regions that we live in.
This COVID is one of these zoonotic diseases that jumps out of wildlife, and you know, it's coming from illegal poaching of wildlife in Southeast Asia. So, you know, you start to disturb and destroy habitats, and you sometimes reap the consequences of that.
We can learn a lot about the virus through these tools in genomics and bioinformatics, and those are important skills that are relevant in the evolution of biology. How do viruses evolve, and what is their RNA, and what can we learn from their RNA? Different things like this are things that evolutionary biologists encounter in bats and pangolins and coronaviruses too.